the story is, but the story is, there is an ashram, there was a guru. A guru had a beautiful daughter and three wonderful shishyas, students. All the three students were in love with the daughter. And each one was better than the other. Each one was so beautiful there. Now the daughter of the guru got so confused who to choose. The story goes, this Bhuta is telling now Virya-Vikramaditya as he is keeping the body on the shoulder, right? So gets confused, right? Who to get, because she can't choose now. She can't choose who it is. She commits suicide. You should not forget those days, Indian women were very conditioned. Nowadays they are very liberated. More liberated than men. Those days they are very conditioned. So therefore, who to choose? Now there's all three. If fourth is included, I don't mind. Right? Those days they have to choose one. Right? To choose one, get so confused because emotionally she was connected to all three. And right, therefore the story goes, she commits suicide, and she commits suicide. The Bhuta is telling Virya-Vikramaditya, right, gets kind of there. What is this? Now the body has to be burnt. When the body is burnt, the asti, the bones, right, one takes the bones and goes away with the hope he'll chant some mantra and bring back life. He believed in the power of mantras, so he takes one. The other person takes the bones and go and takes bath in all the rivers. Some purification may happen and something can happen. The third person kept the bones where she died and where she was burned. With the certain bones, she was just there itself, this place. So the first person was there with a miracle that she may come back. That was the passion of love. Right? The other person takes there, protects the bones, just protects it, goes on giving bath. The third person just goes to learn some mantra, yantra and tantra, so that bring back life. This Bhuta is telling Virya-Vikramaditya, as he is going all the way back to his guru in the graveyard, and he is not supposed to talk, at the same time be very aware. And also there is another condition, which other condition is, if you know the answer and if you don't tell, then I'll kill you right now. There's another further in life also it is so complicated. If you know the answer and if you don't tell right now, I'll kill you. And if he tells the answer, wink, it goes back. In life sometimes it's so complicated. And the third one he gives was, right, now the third person was just there itself where she died. Now, who, and then this person who goes getting mantra, etc., discovers a certain mantra. A guru gives him the mantra and says, take the bones of her, chant the mantra, which this man did not have the bones, chant the mantra at the same spot where she died and she was burned, then she'll come back to life. One guru told this person. So that person now, he didn't have any asti bones. He rushes to the spot. He finds this person. He says, where are the bones? He says, I do not know. I am here itself. But it is with the second shishya who has gone there. He always goes to Ganga. He rushes there to that person. He has it. And he tells, I have learned, got the mantra. Takes the bone, comes to the spot, utters the mantra. She comes back to life. This time she is more beautiful. Now, who is she going to marry? Who is she going to marry? There's a question there. If you know the answer and don't answer, I will kill you. And if he answers, the Bhuta goes back. Like this 27 or 28 stories comes. It's mind-stimulating stories. And if Vikramaditya knew the answer, if he doesn't say, he doesn't get killed, he will get killed. And therefore finally he gets the answer. Right? The one who has given, who has chanted the mantra and given back birth to this girl, he is more like a father given birth. The one who has protected the bones, that person is more like a son who is protecting. But the person who waited for her, waited, that is a lover. So she will marry that person. right? Then the body goes back. Like this it comes. Finally, Vikramaditya could get, and finally, without speaking, could reach this. And friends, if you see this, the whole purpose of this is two things. Be very aware and also be silent. Silent is, can we be relaxed? The Gita is going to take Ma Shuchaha when he said this. Don't worry. The Gita starts with Ashochyan Anvashochastvam Prajna Vadhamscha Bhashase Gatasun Agatasumscha Panditahan Anuchochanti. Starts of Ashochyan, the 11th verse of the 2nd chapter, the Gita really starts and ends with Ma Shuchaha, do not worry. So the whole message of the Gita is remove your shoka, your sorrow. And the message of the Gita is the shoka, sorrow is eliminated if you remove the cause of the sorrow. And the cause of the sorrow, shokasya karanam mohaha, the cause of your sorrow, shoka, is moha. So therefore the essence of the Gita is eliminate your shoka by removing the cause of the shoka, which is moha. When moha is eliminated, shoka is eliminated. Nahi jnanena sadrisham pavitram iha vidyate. There is nothing more pavitra than understanding. And therefore for personal excellence, this understanding, this knowledge, if it has to dawn, you have two conditions, it is there. One, you have to be extremely aware like Veera Vikramaditya, and inwardly very silent. Inwardly silent. If you are not aware and not silent, you are not going to gain wisdom. It will only gain in concepts. Lot of people think if they can rattle out the Gita, quote the mantra, by rattling out the Gita and quoting the mantra without being existentially aware, and without being inwardly silent, that is only be only words, words and words. The word is not the thing, the description is not the describe. Please get this very clearly before I start dwelling with on personal excellence. Because lot of people have read the Gita, it just becomes words. So therefore, if it has to be words as you are listening to these 4 days, be so alert. One, inwardly so silent. You have to be alert and to be silent. When you are alert and you are silent inside, if you understand, well and good. If you don't understand, don't worry. For Hindus, no problem. This Janma is not there. We have many Janmas. Whereas other people in one Janma, they have to exhaust. For us, Janma is there. That's why Hindus are very relaxed people. Alright? So therefore, don't worry. But just being relaxed is one part, but you have to be aware. If right now certain points I am saying to you, you are not understanding, be relaxed, don't get worried, because worry is like a rocking chair, it keeps you busy but leads you nowhere. So don't worry, first control you should have, first nigraha. Now, okay, I don't worry, the whole house is burning, yes, I don't worry, that is pyjama type of worry. Pyjama type of silence, because graveyard silence is there, the silence of a rose garden is there. So please see these distinctions. Alright? If you don't understand, first don't worry. Second, that is not enough. Become more aware. Just the story of Vikramaditya. Be more aware, at the same time be silent. And if you are aware and if you are silent, these two joins and mixes together. And a certain synergy is created. And the synergy is created. You don't and get just knowledge, jnanam. You will get vijnanam. In the Gita, please, for personal excellence, knowledge is not enough. Jnanam vijnanam cha. Lord Krishna says, jnana and also vijnana means intelligence. Your knowledge should result in intelligence. Knowledge is repeat like a parrot. But intelligence is a very different ball game altogether. And when you have intelligence, Lord is going to say, even in a conflicting situation, you can be in harmony. Even in a conflicting situation, you can have an harmony. And this is the principle of warfare. And meditative type of warfare, is in a conflict, don't create a conflict. For example, you get angry. When you get angry, then you get angry that you are angry, then double-decker anger. Then you feel guilty that you are angry, that you are angry. Then you get upset that you are guilty, you are angry, you are angry. Then you get ashamed. I have attended so many workshops of Swamiji, paid thousands of rupees, all wasted. And then you are again upset. Then dabba pe dabba pe dabba pe dabba, and you feel miserable. But instead of that, friends, you get angry. Create an harmony with that anger. When you create a harmony with anger, you experience anger. When the moment you experience anger, then you will see the cause and the genesis of anger. And when you see the cause and the genesis of anger, that very cause will diffuse. Karana abhave karya abhavaha. When you remove the cause, the effect is gone. Therefore, in martial art, right, there's a simple thing which is the essence of the Gita, in fact. Don't create a conflict in a conflict, create a harmony in a conflict. Yaha sarvatra anabhisneha yat yat prapya shubha shubham napi nandati nadveshti tasya prajna pratishthita. Lord Krishna says, yaha sarvatra anabhisneha. Don't get attached to success or failure. When you are not attached to success or failure, you are at state of peace with what is. To what? Shubha ashubham. Towards your good and ashubham, not good. Not good is a bad. Bad means conflict. Even to our conflict, create an harmony. I'll try to avoid using too much of Sanskrit so you will understand. Or else you'll get new tension called Sanskrit tension. Alright, so trust me, what I'm saying is the Bhagavad Gita now. So in between, I will slice it. Or else you may think it's my masala I'm talking. Alright, I'll just introduce the verse, after you refer the books properly. Or else if I do mimamsa to that, it'll take a lot of time because I'm touching on the top of a personal excellence. The sloka here, yaha sarvatra anabhisneha, is only means create a harmony in conflict. That's why in martial art, I'm also a student of martial art because I'm teaching Bhagavad Gita. No? Because I'm the first Swamiji who know, who is also a belt holder in martial art. And there we see, in my workshops I demonstrate, somebody tries to attack you. Right? Somebody, the first lesson I learned is, somebody holds your neck, shoulder, like attacks you. First my master told me, relax. Because maximum you will die. Anyway, we are going to die. By this you will relax better. Once he holds you, pushes you here and there, you are first be relaxed. Once you are relaxed, you are centered. Please get the word. In martial art this is used. You are centered. Once you are centered, see, holding your shirt, moving, be relaxed. Be relaxed. Because when you are relaxed, you are centered. Once you are centered, as you're relaxing, then the next step is you enter and break his center. I can't do a demonstration on that. Right? You enter and break his center of gravity. That's why Sivanand will accept, I'm sure he'll endorse what I'm saying. To a drunkard, the police people don't hit. Because they're so relaxed. Fuck you, hit me, that one will fall. A person is drunk, a drunk person is extremely relaxed. So police people generally don't hit a drunkard, their hand will pay. Because they're so relaxed, they hit him and he just falls. But when you become very consciously and fall, you become rigid. When rigid, you get injured. So the first thing in martial art, in warfare, I started learning martial art because I wanted, since I'm talking at the Gita, know this, right? Once you hold, push you, be relaxed. Right? Once you don't resist, you are going with the flow. When you are going with the flow, you are centered. And once you are centered, as you are going the flow, then you poke his eyes, hit his throat, smash his jaws, right, in that flow. Therefore, the whole principle is this for personal excellence. Create a harmony in conflict. Yeah.